Worship at Stone House Presbyterian Church, and with our family scattered all around the country, all around the world, let us celebrate together. For behold, I bring you good news of great tidings and great joy. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. Come, let us adore him. Come, let us worship.
A reading from Isaiah chapter 9, verse 2, 6, and 7. The people who have walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in the land of deep darkness, on them the light has shined. For a child has been born to us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness. From this time onward and forevermore, the zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this.
Oh, 1:26-38, the birth of Jesus foretold. In the sixth month of Elizabeth's pregnancy, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. The virgin's name was Mary. The angel went to her and said, "Greetings, you who are highly favored, the Lord is with you." Mary was greatly troubled at his words and wondered what kind of greeting this might be. But the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you are to call him Jesus. He will be great, and he will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over Jacob's descendants forever. His kingdom will never end." "How will this be?" Mary asked the angel, "since I am a virgin." The angel answered, "The Holy Spirit will come on you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God. Elizabeth, your relative, is going to have a child in her old age, and she who was said to be unable to conceive in her sixth month, for no word from God will ever fail." "I am the Lord's servant," Mary answered. "May your word to me be fulfilled." The angel left her.
Oh, one and two.
From the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 1, verses 18 through 24. Now the birth of Jesus the Messiah took place in this way. When his mother Mary had been engaged to Joseph, but before they lived together, she was found to be with child from the Holy Spirit. Her husband Joseph, being a righteous man and unwilling to expose her to public disgrace, planned to dismiss her quietly. But just when he had resolved to do this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for the child conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you are to name him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins." All this took place to fulfill what had been spoken by the Lord through the prophet. "Look, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and they shall name him Emmanuel," which means God is with us. When Joseph awoke from sleep, he did as the angel of the Lord commanded him. He took her as his wife.
Angels
reading from the prophet Isaiah, the 11th chapter, beginning with the first verse. A shoot shall come out from the stump of Jesse, a branch shall grow out of his roots. The Spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him, and the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of the knowledge and the fear of the Lord. His delight shall be in the fear of the Lord. He shall not judge by what his eyes see or decide by what his ears hear, but with righteousness he shall judge the poor and decide with equity for the meek of the earth. The wolf and the lamb shall lie down together. The leopard shall lie down with the kid, the calf and the lion and the fatling together, and a little child shall lead them. The cow and the bear shall graze. Their young shall lie down together. The lion shall eat straw like an ox. The nursing child shall play over the hole of the snake, and the weaned child shall put its hand on the adder's den. They will not hurt or destroy on all my holy mountain, for the earth will be full of the knowledge of the Lord as the waters cover the sea. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Spirit upon us, O Lord, that we may hear clearly what you have to say to us. May the words of my mouth and meditations of all of our hearts be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, our rock and our redeemer. Amen. This is Duke. He's our animal in the manger today. He's very interested in baby Jesus, because last night I taught the children how to swaddle. What's the big deal about these swaddling clothes and Jesus lying in a manger? Well, swaddling is taking cloth and wrapping the baby really, really tight and snug so it feels protected and warm, and it calms a crying child down. Now, some people use a baby doll to represent Jesus in their manger, and some people use a flashlight or a lantern because Jesus says he's the light of the world. We used fresh bread.
And it's even baby-sized. How about that? So why bread? Why would I choose bread over any of these other good images for Jesus? It's because the bread is only the beginning of the story. The babe of Bethlehem becomes Jesus of Jerusalem. You have heard it said, Jesus tells his disciples, an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth, but I tell you, love your enemies and pray for those who persecute you. Jesus is teaching a new way of living, a new way of being. It's very different than anything the world had seen then or the world sees now. Jesus teaches us not to focus on ourselves, but to set ourselves apart for love and compassion and service. Jesus teaches us not to hoard the treasures of this world, but to give and share freely. Jesus teaches us not to judge, but to forgive. I am the way, the truth, and the life, he says. I am the true vine. I am the good shepherd. I am the bread of life. And because we are such slow learners, Jesus had to show us exactly what he meant. And so when he and his disciples had gathered around the Passover table, Jesus took the bread and he gave thanks and he broke it and he blessed it and he gave it to his disciples saying, take and eat. This is Christ's body broken for you. And in the same way, he took the cup and he poured it out and he said, this cup is the new promise in my blood shed for you for the forgiveness of your sins. I have a lot of sins that need forgiving. Every day I try to do better, but I still fall short. Even as Jesus hung on that bloody cross, he showed us how to love. He showed compassion to his enemies, and he prayed for those who persecuted him. And the cross is not the end of the story. The tomb is not the end of the story. I am the resurrection and the life. And he rose from the dead, and even that is not the end. Because the story continues in you and in me and in everyone who seeks to learn from Jesus, to live like Jesus, to love like Jesus. This bread is more than bread or the baby in the manger. This bread is an invitation to you. It is an invitation to experience that joy to the world that everybody's singing about. It's an invitation to experience a new way of seeing the world, a new way of being in the world. Set aside the hate and the distrust. Receive compassion and love, and then offer that compassion and love to others. This is an invitation to join the adventure, to discover the adventure of becoming a fully devoted follower of Jesus Christ. And because you're watching this particular Christmas Day service, I bet there's someone sitting with you right now that could tell you about their adventure of following Jesus, about why this way of living has meaning and purpose for them. But if you're already on the adventure, it's time to go tell it on the mountain. Can I get an amen? Amen. Thank you.
pray with me? Emmanuel, God with us, you risk being born into a world such as this. You risk taking on flesh that is fragile, vulnerable, and new. O wonder of wonders and joy of joys, everlasting God, your presence gives us hope on this Christmas day. We come weary, some from a late night spent preparing for Christmas Day, and others come excited, having opened gifts from friends and family. We all come to honor and praise you. We come grateful for all the good gifts with which we have been blessed. And we come to pray, especially for those who are in need of hope today. Help us, Prince of Peace, to respond to your extraordinary love with love of our own. Help us to be present today with family and friends and loved ones while we remember those for whom this holiday surfaces pain and loss. As you have reached out to us in the birth of Jesus Christ, may we reach out to others. Hear our petitions for those in need of your presence and hope. Emmanuel, hear us as we pray for our world, for we pray to an end to the ongoing war in Ukraine. We pray for women of Iran. We pray for those terrorized by extremists, for those longing for peaceful solutions to age-old conflicts. We pray for the oppressed in need of liberation. We pray for evil powers to be overthrown, for wrongs to be made right, for those thirsty for justice to be satisfied. Emmanuel, hear us as we pray for our community. Bind us together in faith and in service. Enlighten us to the needs and the needy right here around us. Help us make room in our communities and in our homes for weary travelers, people like Mary and Joseph in need of a safe place to stay. Help us make room for those who long to belong, but feel left out in the cold. Emmanuel, hear us as we pray for friends and for loved ones. God of compassion, bless us and those we love and those whose names we do not know. Heal those who are suffering from illnesses. Comfort those who have recently lost loved ones, those mourning seats empty at their holiday tables. Protect those without shelter or sufficient heat to combat the bitter cold. Renew those needing respite and strengthen them with holiday Sabbath. Mighty God, whose word we trust and whose spirit enables us to pray, accept our requests and further those which will bring about your purposes for our world. Finally, hear us as we pray together the words Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
child of Bethlehem, descend to us, we pray. Cast out our sin and enter in. Be born in us today. We hear the Christmas angels, their great glad tidings tell. Oh, come to us, abide in us, our Lord Emmanuel. At Stone House, we have a practice at the end of our service of singing, Go On Your Way in Joy. And it's really simple. Go on your way in joy, my friends. And then the tricky part is at the end. Let your left foot say glory and your right say amen. Go on your way in joy, my friends. Go on your way in joy, my friends. Go on your way in joy, my friends. Left your left foot say glory and your right say amen. Let your left foot say glory and your right say amen. Merry Christmas.